Good afternoon. This is Cool Hand. This message is for John Roberts. The Supreme Court Chief. Mr. Roberts, I don't know what your problem, you guys' problem there, but, you know, the President of the United States is not supposed to be above the law. And for our entire history, that's been the truth up until now. So why do you think Donald Trump deserves it? I mean, really, why do you think Donald Trump deserves to be above the law? Is it his nice smile or his lies? Or because he put three justices on the Supreme Court? I mean, you guys have passed dog crap in the past 2 years. You took a law that's been on the book for 40 years that has saved hundreds of thousands of American women's lives, and you took it away from them. Roe. And I wonder how many thousands and thousands of women in the last 2 years have died because of you guys. 15, 20,000 women? I mean, before Roe, there was someplace around 15,000 women a year died because of a botched, unsafe abortion. So I'm guessing half of that? 7,000 or 8,000. It's been 2 years, so 14,000 or 15,000 women probably died because they couldn't get a safe abortion, or because of complications, or because in this country, the most dangerous thing a woman can do is birth a child. One in every 16th woman in this country dies in childbirth. It's very dangerous. You said that bump stocks, well, they're not really making machine guns out of semi-automatic weapons. I'm a gun owner, man. I have semi-automatic weapons. And let me tell you, it's damn close to an automatic weapon with a bump stock. It really is. And there's no need for that shit in this country. No need for it, Chief Justice. You know, I've lost all faith for you people. I used to think Supreme Court was a great place, that you guys used to do a good job. But you haven't. In the last few years, because I've watched your guys, you especially, your hearing, and you said, well, the president is not above the law. That's what you said, John Roberts. And the other guys and women said the same thing. The president isn't above the law. So why are you doing it to us? Why are you giving the presidents, future presidents, the capability of taking bribes and all kinds of shit, and claiming it, they don't, it's above the law. You know, they can't be prosecuted. Why? Why are you doing this to the people of this country? I mean, really. Donald Trump is a twice impeached felon. And this man, because he's a felon, and if he becomes president legally under U.S. law, he can't get a security clearance. There's a law about security clearances. And if you're a felon, you can't get a security clearance. The second thing is, if you're a felon, you can't be near nuclear weapons, have any part in nuclear weapons, you can't get codes, you can't do anything. The president is supposed to be able to have codes to launch her nuclear weapons. Donald's not supposed to do that. He's supposed to have it because he's a felon. I will have to say this, Mr. Roberts, Chief Roberts, you've really fucked this up for everybody. You've really fucked this up. And you should be ashamed. And I hope more people, like today, are picketing outside your house and Scalia's and Mr. Take Big Trips of my donors, Clarence Thomas, and Amy Barrett's house, too. Because what you've done to this country is basically saying the presidents are kings. And they're not. Especially Donald Trump. He should never be allowed to run for president. We should have laws that say if you're a convicted felon, you can't. If you've been found guilty in the House of, you know, of anything, you know, he's been convicted twice by the House. He shouldn't be allowed to run for presidency. The man is a walking, you know, clusterfuck. He really is. He just won't quit. And I know what's going to happen. He's going to do what he said. Chief Roberts, you know, if by chance that man gets in, he will suspend the Constitution, and he will put federal troops on every street in this country, and he will federalize the police. And since he suspends our Constitution, his federal police can kick in our door and haul us away. And the thing is, you basically allowed it because of your giving Donald Trump immunity crap. It's really bullshit. Thank you, my friends, for watching. If you're upset as much as I am, please comment. Please give me a thumbs up. And if you're not a member, subscribe. Please subscribe. I'm a middle road person. I've been to the right a little bit and been to the left a little bit. But I'm middle road. I want peace and security too. I want just a nice society. I don't want a Donald Trump society. And I don't want a crazy far left society. I just want what we've had forever. It's a great country and wonderful people. And, you know, Donald Trump loves to blame immigrants. Well, Donald, I just saw a thing that Robert Reich did. And by the way, those 21 million immigrants that are in our country right now without papers, they're putting over $1 trillion into our economy. And I promise you, boys and girls, if Donald Trump becomes president and he does what he says he's going to do, I hope you like $50 tomatoes and a head lettuce that costs you $30. And when you go to get a hamburger, it's a $75 hamburger, because that's what's going to happen. These people that are bending over in the fields every day for 16 hours, and Americans ain't doing it, you know, are feeding us and doing other things. And I promise you what will happen is the stock market will crash big time. They'll have zero confidence in this bastard, Donald. and it could be really bad for us. So thank you.